बिल्कुल, जस्ट वेट फॉर 2 more minutes फॉर दिस जो है।
अच्छा
Everybody, so I think we can start now. I'm
Sure.
sharing my screen.
Please go ahead, Dharma.
Is it visible?
Yes.
Okay, everyone. So we have a very important session today called Working with a Unit Testing, to tell you like what unit testing can really do. So let me open up my okay. So friends, what we're gonna take you towards is a unit testing. Now I want to tell you like what is a unit testing now. See, in Angular, unit testing is very, very important. Because as a developer, you understand, for any development, what we do, no matter it is any language, unit testing helps us to understand the behaviors are working correct or not. In Angular, similar thing applicable for its own tools too. So in case if you're planning to perform any sort of testing to check the component's behavior. So in Angular, we have one tool available. Okay, we have one tool available, and the tool is known as called Jasmine. Okay, so you have got Jasmine and you have got Karma. So there are the two tools are there. Jasmine is basically the framework, where the Karma is what is actually a test runner. And they are there together from the version 1.x. And they are the best, I would say, the tools used by Angular to make the testing more and more simplified. So let's see how we can do the testing in our Angular. Now remember one thing, any test, whichever you want to develop it, it starts with?
Amarjit. So apart from Jasmine and Karma, we need a protractor also. Protractor is one of the tools to do the testing in Angular, I believe.
See, protractor, see, there are two different type of testings are there. One is called unit testing. Okay. One is called what? Unit testing. So when you talk about unit testing, okay, you use this tool called Jasmine and Karma. There's another type of testing that is called E2E, that is called end-to-end testing.
Yeah.
That you use protractor.
Basically, in my current project, we are planning to do the E2E testing. So to avoid the most kind of any issues. So,
yeah. But even in that case also, you need what? Adjustment.
That is correct. But as per client understanding, we need to go with the protractor also, but we are happy to get that Jasmine and Karma along with protractor.
Yeah, so I will I will take both for you. Yeah. This one and this one both. So we will get the clarity of both the topics.
Yeah, and is it possible to start from protractor, or we have to start from Jasmine?
We have to start with this because we need to know about the, first of all, that testing concepts, how it works. And then we'll talk about protector. So because they are the step-by-step, because we cannot shift directly to the protector because there are certain links which always attach with this. That's why.
Yeah. Thank you, Amarjit. Yeah.
So here we have got these two tools which we are trying to use now. So any test file which ends with what name, spec.ts, is considered as a unit testing. So let's see how it really works. So first of all, you need to understand, wherever I'm having the spec.ts file, I will delete it. The total three specs files, I'm getting it. I'm deleting it. all three specs file. And I would like to type one simple command called ng space test. Oh. And check. And see, you should see this message now. And it is telling you 00 success here behind the scene. So execute this command. In case if you get some errors saying that 3 test case passes, 2 test cases passes, and 5 fails. So make sure that from the every folder you delete the spec.ts file and let me know. Please go ahead and let me know about this. Great, Jasmine and Karma is anyways a part of your existing system. Is everybody all done? Please everybody confirm. So once it is ready, what I would like to do now is here in my program, I want to create a new, in fact, whichever if I have any existing component, I would like to go back and create the new test cases for them. Okay, so I want to go back and create a new test cases to check whether they are working fine or not. Okay, so in the first step, what I will do is, suppose if I have a call app component, app component.ts, you call app component.html. Here, I can add nothing, let HTML to be remain blank. In app.component.ts, it is having just title only. So I would like to create a new file called app.component.spec.ts. Remember, the step must be very, very clear. The file must end with .spec.ts. Now, to make it possible, remember, when you're developing a test case, you always have some predefined functionalities with you. Like you have three functions, like in describe it and before each. So how those functions are related? Describe means it is a test suite where you can have multiple test cases can be joined together. It is actual test case, and before each is the one which will get called before every test case and responsible for. And responsible for what? For initializing the resources whenever you ask for it. Okay, so that's how it is. Now, here in my code, let's see how we can use. So I'm just starting with describe. Inside this, we are saying app component suit, and here we would like to use before each. You see, it is coming as a by default. Okay, this before each and we're using one important feature. See, using this Jasmine is a framework. It will give you these functions like in before each, describe and all. But real components are getting loaded and created using one more library named called Testbed. Which library? Testbed, which is an inbuilt library provided by the Angular tools. So here you're using testbed. You see, it comes from the Angular core testing. So using this testbed, you're saying dot configure testing module. And here we're using declarations, just like in how you do it in the app.module.ts. Because in Angular, they are not depending on any, the third party files or any external files. So they do it by their own. So we're giving the name call app component. So that I did with the declarations now. Okay, so you have got this like that. And now I would like to have the first test case with using it. And now here, what I will do, first step is I will say let fixture equal to testbed dot create component, and here we are giving the name of my component called app component, and then I'm saying let app equal to fixture dot debug element dot debug element dot create instance, sorry, debug element dot component instance, debug element dot component instance. Then we'll say expect, and what we pass app, the variable which you define on the top, app dot to be truthy. That's it. So what is happening now? Here you're just checking whether the app does exist or not. It means this component you're creating, it the instance, whether this git exists or not. So here in before each you initialize, here you are just checking whether they exist or not. So to be truthy will check whether they exist or not. So now here, let's check it again. Okay, so do you see this message here? One of one success. Dhanlakshmi, are you clear? Jayesh, Sagar, everybody, Rohit. Okay, so that's what my first test case which we have written it now. Okay. The next test case, which I'm planning to check, whether the property which we are defining it, that is available or not. Like here, I have got one property, like in what title. I want to check whether this property title itself exists or not. So what I will do, I'll just copy the same. Testing the title value. So fixture.debug element dot create element, fixture.debug element dot components dot app dot. It contains one property here. We just check the name is called title. I'm saying app dot and I'm not using dot to be. I'm using dot to equal dot. What is the value here? Angular app. I'm just checking whether the value is Angular app or not. App.title to be Angular app. Let's check it out again. and see if it is worthy working fine for us. And you should see here. Error. Expected Angular app to be what? Angular app. Just try and check if the code is working fine, please. There's an extra space here. That's why the error was. And you can see now both the test cases are passed. So please check and confirm if your test cases are also working. I'm waiting fine for all of you. Please confirm and check and let me know. Do update me if it is working fine, please. Okay, everybody, so this is ready and we are using this expected value. The third thing is important to check whether the values which we are probably passing in my HTML, that is same or not. So here, let me use this H3 tag, and in this curly braces, I'm providing what title here. Let me check the values are same or not. So in my app.component.spec.tsc, what I'm trying to use now, I'm saying if and let's check its value. I'm saying let compiled equal to okay. So we're using this open like a fixture dot debug element. Okay, debug element dot. Native element. We know it very well what the fixture is. Okay, so fixture dot debug element dot native element, or else what we can do is here I just copy the same. And element, and after this, once it is ready, you can just use this option like an expect. Okay, you can just say compiled dot query selector. Okay, compiled dot query selector, and here you're selecting what the tag. I'm selecting which tag. Let me check. It is H3 tag. So rather than using this H1, you use what? S3. Okay. Dot text content dot to contain what is the name? Angular app. That's all. So this is checking whether the value of this H3 using query selector is the same or not. That's the difference. Just check and confirm if it is working. Please confirm, guys, if it is working fine. Everybody, please confirm your answers in the chat if it is working fine for everybody. If it is working, I just want to give you one small task now. Everybody, the task is like, here in my TS file, I want to define one variable here, like title we have defined, that is known as call. Tune. Okay, I want to test this property, not only for this, but also in my HTML. I would like to go with what? The property city. Can I test the city property for the HTML and also for this value, which is the value is city equal to Pune? Jayesh, Dhanalakshmi, Sagar, everybody, can we? Please confirm, can we? So please try and go ahead and try developing it and let me know once it is ready, please.
So can you show that component.spec.ts? Hello. Hello, sir.
Tell me.
Yeah, can you just show that spec.ts?
Everybody, so it seems like it is working fine for all of you. Now it's time to talk about our next logic. That logic is like, what in case if I want to test my other portions of my applications too? Like what I'm trying to say, see, I can test many things. I can test my directives. I can test my pipes. Many things I can test during my applications development. So here I want to test my directives now. Everybody, what I want to test? My pipe. So let's go back and test our pipe. So here I'm going to create a new file under the app and give the name call. New file and give the name call. As the name suggests, we are using this particular pipe, so we are using this call import, or else leave it, just use directly call export. Okay. So and we also want to use implement pipe. And here I use the transform function, which takes a value of like what, a string, and say return value dot split. Okay, value dot split dot reverse dot join. Here above we are saying at the rate pipe. Okay, and that's it. You can give the name here. Call. Right, once it is done, my next step will be, I want to test this pipe is correct or not. Okay, so to make it happen, I would like to just create another file here. So we want to create the test case for this particular pipe. Okay, so we are saying reverse dot spec.ts, and here I will say describe it and we will just use a keyword called let rp equal to new of reverse pipe object. We are creating it here and expecting what, everybody, expect. We are calling which function? Transform, passing some value called hello. Okay, and it's saying what? Dot to equal. What will the reverse for this? That's it. So this is how we are testing it. Just check and confirm whether this is working fine for all.
Sir, how to check this? I mean, the previous code which I had written. So how we can check?
Which one? I didn't get.
Means the test cases which you are creating. So how to check that it is correct or not?
correct or not means like, see, if the test case will fail, you're going to get the message here saying this expected is not matching with that. So you're going to get the error here itself in the console.
And so for the previous code which we have written, that in app component dot spec, yes.
Okay.
So can you just show me just one example?
Can I share this with you?
Yeah, I have the code. But how to test that only thing I just want.
Just type ng space test.
Okay.
Just type
in console, ng. Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's it.
Ng space test, right?
Test here.
So actually, the another browser has opened, that Karma Debug Runner, and in that I can see incomplete, no specs found.
No specs found.
Right.
Just check the location is correct, because all files are end with .spec.ts file. You see this now?
Okay, wait.
Please do let me know if the code is working fine, please. Need any help, guys, do let me know. But once it is done, please update me.
So actually, I'm getting that same in that new browser. Additional incomplete no specs found.
Can you share your screen?
Yes, sure. Yeah, it should be like this.
Complete no spec found. Can I see the terminal? 00 specs. Go back to the code. Go back to the code, please.
We have to mention that H3 title, right?
Yeah, that not that particular VS Code editor.
Have I done any mistake in here?
No. Just open the app.component.spec.ts file here. So do one thing. Line number 80. Line number 75, you copy testbed.createComponent.appComponent.
Actually, sir.
No. Only right hand side, only after equal to. Only you copy. Yeah, copy. And replace this fixture with this. Save it. And now check. See, now it is telling you 6 out of 8 fail because you haven't deleted other spec.ts file. So except app.component.spec.ts file, you have to delete all the other spec.ts files. Are you clear? From the different folders, like in header, footer, and all. And then tell me, is it okay?
Acha. So that is the test case means you have to check.
Yeah, app component spec.ts ko chhod ke baaki jitne bhi spec un sab ko delete karo. Like wherever you have created a spec.ts file, you delete it, rest all. It'll work. Okay, ab check karo, then I will let me know once it is ready.
Okay.
Everybody, please confirm whether this test case is working fine for all of you or not. Which is your reverse pipe.
So now it is showing one fail and two success in the terminal, and in the browser Karma, it is showing the three specs, one failure. Expected that blank to contain Angular app. Hello. Hello, sir.
Excuse me.
Yeah, in the browser it is showing that three specs, one failure.
So whichever is failure. That you need to check, no? Which one is failure? Make sure that none of the spec.ts files are available under the app folder. So whichever subfolders are there, delete all the spec.ts file from everywhere, except one, the one which you have.
There is one that ts config.spec.json we have. I don't think that it will get some problem.
No, not that.
Other than that, I have deleted other spec.ts.
See, under the app folder, you should have only one .complaint.spec.ts file. If you have anywhere .complaint.spec.ts file under the app folder, you delete it and check it out again.
Yes, actually, there are no other specs in that app.
Can you share your screen? Let me help you.
Yes, sure, sure. So this is my app folder. So I have written a spec.ts.
So what error are you getting it may know?
So in terminal I'm getting like this. Executed
1 kill 2 success. 1 second, give me a second.
It is showing that a main name is not a known element. So shall I comment it?
I'm checking 3 of 2. The comment line number 79 to line number 82. Save it and check. It's working.
Huh.
Now you check for this the third option which I told you, that's for pipe one and confirm.
But what the issue I'm getting for this line?
That I need to check about, there will be some type of mistake or something that I need to check. So I'll just let you know in a while. Yeah?
So in the app count config, I have written title as Angular app. Is it correct or I need to consider this previous one?
Sorry?
In the title, we are looking for Angular app, right?
Yeah, very much.
Okay.
Now you check for the one which we are having, that is called Pipe.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Everyone, last 2 more minutes, kindly finish it off and do let me know. Everybody all set? For Jayesh, it is working fine. Dhanalakshmi, what about you?
Rohit, any update? Vanisha, Vijay Raj? Everybody, if it is done, then can we go and take a break now? Yes, everybody, can we go and take a break? Okay, so see you after a few minutes to start our session. Okay, thank you. Hello everybody, so are we all back from the break? Please confirm. Hello everybody, please confirm. Are we all back from the break? Everybody, so now we're going to talk about testing other options too. Let me close all the files, and now I'll be testing my services. See, we know how to test components, we know how to test pipes. It's time to know what in case if I want to test my services. Okay, so in case if you want to know how to test my services, let's take a look now. Here in our main component, okay, to test my services, so under my app, I'm going to create a new file here called data service. Data service dot, which option, data dot service dot ts or data service dot. Service.ts. This data service.ts, what we are saying, export plus data service. Let's make D capital. Okay. Now we are using one function called getDetails. In this getDetails, we are using const. Equal to take two parameter resolve reject. Okay, it's just a parameter here. Now here we'll be using which option? Set timeout, giving the timeout time call what? 1500 millisecond. And here we are saying resolve it, something like this. Okay, and now we are saying return that promise, that is called result promise. That is the service which we have created. Okay, so once the service is ready, would like to go back and use another type of service into my code, which is called user.service.ts. Now, new file, user.ts. In this user.service.ts, we are just saying export plus user service. Okay, and say simple object user. That's it. That's it. So these are the two services which are there, which I would like to perform a test. So please get ready with these two services and let me know.
Sir, can I show the data service? Okay.
Everybody, so if it is done, then it's time to basically check whether the service is working fine or not. Okay, so the previous spec file which I'm having it, which is your app.component.spec.ts. Okay, now since I want to test that, so what I'll be doing now, let's take a look. Here, dot component instance, I just copy the same here. Okay, testing the. Service. Okay, and. So we're talking about testing the service, fix it equal to testpec dot create component. So we had a called app component and all. See, component will also be using this service. Isn't it or not? Everybody, if you see, the component will be also using what? This service to get the job done. So how are you going to be using this now? Everybody, how are you going to be injecting it this now? Because if I have an app component with me, app.component.html or whatever it is, I'm having it now. So this app.component.ts. Okay, this app.component.ts, somewhere I have to inject this. So what I need to do, constructor. Okay, and this service which we have created, user service. Okay, I'll be just making this a what? An I'm just putting into the provider section. App.module.ts. Okay. So inside this constructor, we are just using this beta service and what the user service both. So here you can also provide what data service. And above this data service also will be using what like this. Now our app.component.ts in my constructor we are saying private user service. And here post this we would like to use this in this engine I'm using this option I can have some properties defined here so I'm defining this like in user okay and data okay what we're saying user and data so we are providing this dot user equal to user service dot user we're using data equal to ds dot get details because it is returning the promise object back to me. So we are using what everybody dot then data clear. So okay. So we are basically injecting this data just like that. Okay, so that's the initial case which I'm having it now. In case if you want to print it, okay, you can also print the value to tell like whether the user is logged in or not, or whatever the issues are. Okay, so in order to make it possible, what you can do, you can just use one variable called what. Is logged in equal to what false and define this variable here in my HTML app.component.html. So what you can do now here and just use div tag and say star ngif equal to is logged in. So here you say that is what you're printing it now. So I'll copy this, paste it. We'll be using the same condition, but I'll be using exclamatory mark. User not logged in. Quickly, please go back and develop this and let me know once you're ready, please. Go back and develop and let me know once you're ready. And to check if it is working fine or not, so what you can do is you can perform the test cases along with. Okay, so okay, so to basically test this particular application, the one which I'm telling you right now. Okay, so what we need to do, let me first terminate this. Okay, so test this service, what I will do is we will use the same. Paste the same testing the service. Okay, sorry, I already have this testing the service. Yeah, I'm having this option called testing the service app component. Component instance. Now the main important thing we'll be using it here is let user service equal to fixture dot debug element dot, here we'll be using this option like an injector. Can you see this option like an injector dot get here, because you're injecting the service. So which service you're injecting here? Everybody, use a service. Once again. And checking by using fixture dot detect changes to confirm whether the changes has been made. And later on you can say expect user service. Okay, dot user dot name. The thing, user service dot user dot name dot to equal and give the value to what app dot user dot name. It's like this. Are we clear? So you're just verifying the service which you're injecting it, that name is equivalent to that or not. That's the whole idea. Okay, so now you check and confirm whether the test case is working fine for all of you.
me know, guys, once the code is working fine for all. Copying and pasting this content right on a code share. At least you can go and check if it is working. This is for testing. This is for app component TS. This is your data service. And this is the user service. So friends, the entire code snippet has been shared. Now I request you to please quickly confirm and check if it is working fine for all. I've shared the entire code set for all of you. I think I've done it in app.module.ts translation. The only thing is I've just declared both the services here.
with me, is it working fine for you? Yeah, Dhanalakshmi, is it working fine for you? Others, everybody? Lakshmi, I would request you to kindly check the complete flow and recheck it again and see where you have missed out the environment. Okay. So guys, then that's it what we're keeping it for today. I request you to whichever is pending, you try to finish it up because tomorrow we'll be working on end-to-end testing using Protractor. Okay. So we'll be spending quality time on tomorrow talking about how the end-to-end testing really works. And some input regarding this NGRX will also be giving it to you, which is called state management. How to do the state management. Okay, everybody? Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say, Dhanalakshmi. I have shared that code with you. So just review that because see, here there's no error. It is working perfectly fine. Okay. So,
Rajit, can you show your output?
Which one?
For this, because you have not run it. Because I don't think we have provided the services in the testbed.
In a?
Testbed. We need to provide the services in the testbed, right? In the spec.
Which testbed you're saying?
In the spec.ts, app component spec.ts, where we create the testing module as a testbed.
So you have to do one thing, just the one which you're talking about, spec.ts file. So as you can see, called declaration. So you can
upload. Yeah. So we need to provide it here, right?
Yeah, you have to also.
That was missing. That's why the code was not working.
Yeah. So you can provide this user service also, and it's going to work for you. Okay. So that is by default, because if you're using the declaration, so but obviously you'll be expecting what the other portions do. Okay. Hope clear, everybody. Dhanalakshmi, are you clear? Jayesh, everybody, all clear? Okay, so guys, that's it what we are keeping it for today. Okay, so we'll be seeing you back again tomorrow to take this development ahead. Okay, everyone. So enjoy your time and have a great day ahead. We'll see you back tomorrow. Okay, thank you very much.